Well, do you ever think about, you know, I knew this person when, before she was like before she was Angelina Jolie. Okay, I'm going to introduce you to the next Angelina Jolie. She's beautiful, she's talented, she excels in multiple roles. Her name is Margo Quinn, and she is an up-and-coming actress who is just defying description and bursting boundaries, and it's so great to have you here.
Being compared to Angelina Jolie, let's keep going.
we're going to be able to say we know mm-hmm. we knew her when.
So. Absolutely.
Which means you'll have to come back.
Oh, I'll come back tomorrow.
So that's before right. we do that, let's talk about what you're doing now.
Yeah, right now I'm in post-production for a lot of films. My film, The Attack of the Unknown, comes out this year, I think towards the end of the year, which has Tara Reid and Richard Grieco.
Oh, nice.
So it has some
You're in good company.
Yes,
yes,
you are.
Got a lot of learning to do from these people.
Uh-huh.
How did you get started?
I first got started when I lived in South Dakota, and I played soccer, and I did modeling for pageants when I was little. Nothing like the pageants you see now with a bunch of makeup and mm-hmm. hairspray. It was all natural.
Well, you're speaking to Utah's junior Miss.
Ooh!
Isn't that right?
America's junior Miss.
Oh, that's even
I
better.
I'm sorry.
I
missed America's junior Miss.
Wow, we are in the presence
of an
icon.
It was a lot, but I did the big hair, I did the makeup, I did it all.
You did.
I did.
And she obviously did it well.
Yeah, you did something right.
Anyway, keep going.
So I had a soccer injury, uh-huh. and I wanted to be a professional soccer player, do something with athletics, mm-hmm. and I couldn't play anymore after my surgery, and I said, Mom, Dad, I want to get more into acting and modeling. And they were like, okay, you live in South Dakota. Like, yeah. slow your roll. Like, and my dad was like, well, you either have to be tall and skinny and live in New York, or you got to move to LA and do acting. And I was like, okay, let's go. And that's what we did. We picked up and we went.
Your parents,
the whole family.
Picked you all?
My parents are builders, so they are able. It's not like a teacher where you have to get that job. Mm-hmm. There's anywhere. You can build anywhere, you know?
Oh, that's
so
incredible.
I'm so, so blessed with the family I got.
Wow. That is really amazing. And the role that you have coming up is about a dysfunctional family.
Yes.
Totally unlike your current family.
Yes.
So tell us about
a little more dysfunctional.
Tell us about this the movie coming up.
So I have a movie coming out, For Your Own Sake, and it's a comma, dramedy, like, it's funny and drama-filled. So it's a movie about a family that is having an intervention for their dad. And the dad gets mad, storms out, and is like, I'm not doing this. Leaves, goes to his car, and as he's at his car, some guy comes, an escaped convict comes up behind him and holds a gun to his back. And he's like, I'll give you all my money, I'll give you my car, I won't say anything. And the guy's like, I don't need any of that, I just need to lay low for a few days, stay in your house. So he comes in our house and holds us hostage in our own house for a few days.
Wow.
So it has suspense, it has a lot of funny moments, but it's...
And some family bonding, I'm guessing.
Absolutely. Whether you like it or
otherwise,
not.
Otherwise, you all end up killing each other.
No.
It's the dysfunctional family that is brought together by the escape convict.
By the escape convict.
Yeah, I mean, the premise
I've seen
is
it happen every day.
Oh, yeah.
That's amazing. So what is your ultimate goal? What type of roles do you really enjoy? And then I have one more question, too, about tips that you have for people's kids and grandkids in our audience that want to get involved.
So for types of roles that I enjoy, I like anything that can push me to become better as mm-hmm. an actress. I mean, as a sports player, you want to be on the best team. I want to be with those best directors, those best producers, the mm-hmm. crew. I mean, the actors get things done, but mm-hmm. nothing gets done without the crew mm-hmm. and the people behind the scenes.
That's right.
So any role, anything that pushes me to become better, I love it. I love just being able to grow, mm-hmm. being able to find those emotions and put them in that toolbox and bring them for later.
What a great attitude. Amazing. Yeah, and are you loving California?
Oh, I love it. Yeah. I mean, the traffic.
We won't discuss that.
Yeah. How long have you been here?
Since my sophomore year of high school, so about 5 years now.
How big is the group of people in acting?
Oh my gosh.
Is it huge?
It is beyond big.
Really?
Everyone and their grandma does acting. Uh-huh. I mean, literally, there's grandmas in movies. Everyone and their grandma does acting.
Well, it's good. We need diversity in
acting.
Exactly.
Right. It's like anyone can be an actor.
So there's not like a real tight-knit community in LA?
Oh, it's very tight-knit. It's all who you know.
Okay.
It's all where you can get your foot in the door, mm-hmm. and it's your job to push the door the rest of the way open, but... Sure. I mean, mm-hmm. it's all about who you know and who you can get connected with.
Interesting.
Well, it sounds like a good amount of talent doesn't hurt.
Oh, absolutely.
That's right. Some charm, maybe some sports skills for particular roles. So
yeah, that always helps.
To Amy's question, which I love, is what tips would you give someone looking to enter the field right now?
Independent films are really how nobody's become somebody's. Not mm. to be rich and famous, but to get through those cracks where you can work with these A-listers. Mm-hmm. And independent films are really what get those people out there. You mm-hmm. know, they pick up the nobody and make them, okay, you can have this lead role. Like, wow, like mm-hmm. a lead role, you don't have to be a A-lister like Jennifer Lawrence or mm-hmm. these people that you hear all the time. So my advice would be, keep trying. Mm-hmm. Always. You're going to get 100 no's before you get one yes. But mm-hmm. that one yes will bring you three more opportunities that you had no idea were in the works.
I love that. That's great life advice.
Life in general,
regardless,
yes.
Yeah, of the industry. What about, let's say that somebody's granddaughter really wants to get into it and she's 12 years old. What would you tell her to do?
Get into acting classes. Mm-hmm. First things first, you need to get into acting classes, whether you audition to get into one or you do walk-ins and mm-hmm. you sit through a class and see if you like how they teach. Just basic acting skills first. Mm-hmm. And then slowly get an agent, get a manager. Got to wait for them to have something to manage before you get a manager. Mm-hmm. And just, it's slowly but surely.
Just walk the process.
Exactly.
Go through the process.
Exactly.
There really are no shortcuts.
And there's no right way to do it. Mm-hmm. There's no right way. There's no wrong way. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's the wrong people in the business. There's bad people everywhere in the world. But mm-hmm. everyone wants to work with the same people over and over again. Mm-hmm. So if you make your good first impression, there's a good chance those people will want to work with you again in the future.
It's like anything. You yeah. always want to be invited back.
It really is.
Exactly.
It really is. It's kind of like any profession. Like you said, no shortcuts.
There you go.
Everybody. And the other thing, too, is like, so my family is, they spent 50 years in the entertainment industry.
Wow.
And that is one thing that I have learned is that there are no shortcuts. There are no meteoric rises to fame without the work behind mm-hmm. it. You can't,
and you work hard.
Yes, you can't get by on your beauty. You mm-mm. have to have the talent.
It's all what happens behind closed doors. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can say you want to do acting, and there's always people that do it for the wrong reasons. The people that go in and say, I want to be rich and famous, mm-hmm. I'm sorry, but you're not going to make it in the business.
Yeah.
It's the people that truly have the drive to want to be a performer, create, mm-hmm. let people just tap into those parts of the brain or parts of different sides of the world experience those things.
I think that is fundamentally what's the most important is doing the art for art's sake. Mm-hmm. I think that is like fundamental.
Do it for the right reasons.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep. As The Bachelor says, you have to be there for the right reasons.
Pilot Pete.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today. We're so excited to follow your career, and
thanks.
You are just absolutely delightful. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
We'll see you again.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.